Hi, I'm Mason, and I'm in the studio today with John Bubinick, who's also known as the Color Craftsman, and today we're talking about fireplaces, and in particular, I wanted to ask John about updating fireplaces that are obviously dated. Can you give us an example and walk us through the process?
Sure, we've got some pictures here. Let's show those.
Sure.
This first picture you see, a fireplace that was built in the 1950s. It had a characteristic feel to it. Rather than a mantle, it had these three shelves on the fireplace. Next picture, you can see how they protruded out from the surface. Our first task was to get rid of those. We took them out with a hammer and chisel, and then came and filled in that cavity with an engineered cement that would allow us to shape and repeat that same style of stone to match the adjacent ones.
But obviously when you see the different colored cement there, wouldn't that be an eyesore?
If you didn't color it, it sure would be.
But how do you go out, coloring brick, I guess, tell me how that went. I'm curious to see how this turned out.
So coloring is a matter of a few different things. You've got white, black, and then you've got red, blue, and yellow. And you mix those, some or all of those, until you come up with something that matches the stone around it. So you do it enough and it becomes pretty much second nature. It's not too much of a challenge to come up with a color that matches that stone. Sometimes it's more than one color. That's where the trick comes in, is you have to be able to identify, well, what's the base color and what is a secondary color or tertiary color to go with it. But like I say, you do that for a while and it becomes familiar enough territory.
And I've seen some of your work to the point that I know that he can actually make the stuff look like it's natural brick.
That's
it hasn't
one.
Been painted, which is really pretty awesome. I don't know how you do it, but part of the magic, I guess. But
that's it.
It's pretty amazing.
Good. I'm glad you like it. In the next photo, you see that we added a mantle. And this customer had a particular request. She said she had this fire screen that was a family heirloom, and it had a little detail up at the top on it. And she was hoping that we could put some kind of a reference to that on the new mantle. So on the supports of the mantle, we were able to find a piece of wrought iron that we attached, and that kind of ties in then with that fireplace screen. One other concern this customer had is she said it bothered her that the brick of the hearth didn't match the stone on the rest of the fireplace. And so we have at our disposal a self-leveling cement that we applied over that hearth to cover all the brick and create a smooth stone surface. And in this case, she wanted something gray to cover all that up. The problem was that what she had originally was close, but not quite right. And to make it farther away in color was fine. It didn't look like it was close without matching. And so that took care of her concerns, and we're glad to be able to help.
Great. John, as always, thank you for coming in and sharing your expertise and some of your handiwork. I really think that what you do expands people's perception of what's possible, and I certainly know that every time I sit down and talk with you, I get to see new things and that I didn't even know were possible.
Great. Well, if folks want to get in touch with us, they can reach us at colorcraftsmen.com, and that's M-E-N, not M-A-N. And when they call or email or text, we'll ask them a few questions. We'll ask them what they like about their fireplace, what they don't like, and we'll ask them if they have some ideas of the direction they want it to go. And oftentimes we can come up with a plan over the phone. Otherwise, we'll go out to the location and look at it. And that gives us a chance to see more about the person's style, their taste, as we look at the rest of the house, the rest of that room. And it helps us to limit our suggestions, because otherwise there's a zillion things that can be done. And we need some help to be able to narrow the scope and give them just what fits for their personality and their taste.
I guess one of the only other things worse than not having any options is too many options.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So the fact is you can help in both those areas. So
sure.
Thank you very, very much.
Yeah.
Appreciate your time.
Appreciate you asking.